Hi. Welcome to the tutorial of easy rendering in Keyshot with Render Kit. This is a package of resources that I created for sculptors to help them in a quick and beautiful presentation of their artworks. You can find the link in the description to this video. According to the method I suggest, a good-looking render can be made up of three components: material, light, and background. In the Keyshot, I use two types of lighting, so there are four components. And each of these types of resources can be found in quantities in this tool, giving you the freedom to combine them and get countless render variations. I have already found some good-looking combinations, which you can find in the PDF that comes with the product. Let's start by importing resources. Open KSP file. Select a folder to unpack the package. Okay. Now we need to import the resources to the library. Select Materials tab, create a new folder, name it, and import KMP file by clicking this icon. Next, import backplate images in the same way. Create a new folder and import all images from the backdrops folder there. And the last one is environments. Do the same here. Okay, import your model to the scene. I will use one of my sculptings. Drag and drop it into the real-time render window or use File menu. It is very important to set the scale and position of your model close to the position of the mannequin, as the materials and lights in this scene are adjusted to this position. Press Ctrl plus D to set it properly. Buttons Snap to Ground and Snap to Lower Object can help with this. Also, you can use this menu. I have one locked camera here, but you can add your own or use free camera. Assign a material. Drag it from the library materials bar and drop on your model. The render kit includes 21 custom materials that emphasize the curvature of the surface. They are stylized as clay, resin, 3D printings, and other materials. These environments use the same HDRI maps as default in Keyshot, but with adjusted brightness, saturation, and color tint. Environment creates a fill light, which is visible mostly in the shadows. Important tip: try to match the brightness and warmth of the environment and the backdrop. Then it will look more natural. The second component of lighting is the groups of light sources, consisting mainly of three or four spotlights. To switch the light scheme, click on the eye icon, hide one, and show next. Of course, the color and strength of the spotlights can be edited. Background. If you like to get a finished image directly from a Keyshot without overlaying it in Photoshop on your own background, try using the backplates that are in the render kit. It looks fine, but maybe not very natural. Second option is to use a real background ramp as an object. It reacts to light change and looks really good. You can change its color. And this color will be reflected in the shadows, which gives more realism. Let's have a quick look at the render settings. Select a folder to save image. Select Format. To render with a transparent background, select PNG and include Alpha Channel. Make sure you switched off backdrop ramp. Here's another tip. If you render transparent PNG, use a solid black backplate. Otherwise, you will get a light stroke around the edges of the image, and the shadow will not be transparent. Select next tab called Options. If you have a discrete graphics card on your computer, I recommend you to render on GPU instead of CPU. It gives much faster results for me. The more samples parameter will give you a less noisy image. Finally, click the render button and wait until it is saved in the folder. And that's all. But I have a few more things to show you. Turntable. This feature can be useful not only for animation videos, but also for simple rotation of your model in the scene. Put your model into the turntable group and open animation tab below. This turned out to be a killer feature when you need to render many models from multiple angles because the move tool in Keyshot is pretty inconvenient. Now I can add multiple shots to the queue and render them all with a single button. I also included some bases for the figures and bust stands. Okay, that's all. I really hope that you liked the result and my tool was useful. Feel free to contact me to ask any questions about rendering in Keyshot and Render Kit. Purchase my product by the link below. And thanks for watching. Goodbye.